वेलकम क्लास, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर 8, मैरी क्यूरी। सो मैरी क्यूरी वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन हु वोन नोबेल प्राइज बोथ इन फिजिक्स एंड केमिस्ट्री। नाउ बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर लेट अस सी द वर्ड मीनिंग्स। एपेटाइट, एपेटाइट मीन्स अ स्ट्रांग लाइकिंग फॉर समथिंग, मीन्स यू लाइक समथिंग, दैट इज नोन एज एपेटाइट। Stumbled over, made a mistake. Effortlessly, effortlessly means easily. Afflicted means affected. Recuperation, recovery from illness. Sanatorium, it is a type of hospital for sick people who need rest and a lot of care. Diligent, diligent means one who work very hard and is very careful. Premature, premature means something that is happening before the usual time, before the main time. Boisterous, boisterous means noisy, energetic or cheerful. Forbidden means not allowed. Strain, worry that is caused by having to deal with a problem. So worry which is caused by having a problem. Ordeal, ordeal means a terrible or painful experience. Ordeal means something very painful, and the experience which is very painful. Now let us start the chapter. The Sklodowska family studied together in the evenings so that the parents who were both teachers could help the children Zosia, Bronia, Hela and Josia with their homework. So all the children of Sklodowska family used to study together. Well, Lady Sklodowska had a huge appetite for learning and made sure his children grew up with a respect for education. So, the father of the children, Mary, Josia, Bronia, he thought that whenever his children grew up, they must have respect for the education. One evening, as her 7-year-old sister Bronia stumbled over a passage she had to read aloud, Veldisau and Bronislawa, youngest child, 3.5-year-old Mary or Mania as she was called at home, picked up her older sister's book. So one day Bronia was reading a passage, she had to read it aloud, but however she was not able to read that. So Mary picked Bronia's book and she started reading it. Taking up from the point where Bronia had left off, she began reading fluently, effortlessly from the textbook, completing aware of the astonished expression of her family members. So she started to read the book which was not of her. The book was of her older sister. And she started to read fluently and without any effort. And her family members started to look at Mary with astonished expressions. They were looking at her with astonished expression. When she looked up and saw the almost horrified look on the faces of her parents and siblings, she grew frightened and burst into tears. I did not do that on purpose, she said, explaining her action. It was just so easy. At this, Mary started to explain herself that it was very easy for her. She could read that without any effort. She was reading it without any effort. She was not making any efforts to read it. And while she was looking at her parents, who was looking at her with a horrific expression, with astonished expression, she burst out in tears. And after that, she started to explain her thoughts that it was very easy for her. When Mary was born on November 7, 1867, her mother was a headmistress of one of the Warsaw girls' school adjoining their home. So, Mary's mother was a headmistress of a school, and the school was just beside their house. Mary, who was the youngest of 5 children, would often see her mother struggling with the work of her running house, a big household as well as the school. During these years, the house had many guests. One of these guests was Valdisaw's brother, who came to live with them when he was ill. So, Mary's mother, she used to run her house along with the school. So, it was very difficult for her alone to run this house. So, Mary was seeing her mother running the household, but she was very struggling with the doing work. And during these days, also, Valdisaw's brother came to live with Mary and her family, as Valdisaw's brother was ill. He had tuberculosis, a disease that spread mainly through the germs infected air when somebody who already has the disease coughs or sneezes. So he was affected by the disease tuberculosis. It happens when somebody coughs or sneezes, the germs spread. Unfortunately, this disease afflicted Mary's mother. The disease was then incurable, managed by a series of rest and recuperation treatment in places where the climate was not so cold. As a result, Mary's mother often had to be away from her at a sanatorium where only Mary's oldest sister, Josiah, could go with her. So, when Mary's mother also got affected by tuberculosis, she used to be at sanatorium, which is a hospital, and only Mary's oldest sister Josiah could attend her. When Mary was 9, her sister Josiah died of typhus, but the greatest tragedy of young Mary's life occurred when her mother died at a few months before her 11th birthday. So, her eldest sister Josiah also died because of typhus, and after that her mother also died few months before Mary's 11th birthday. Afterwards, Mary and her sister would often play a make-believe game about a genius doctor who find a miracle cure for a serious illness. So, Mary and her sister would often play games which was make-believe game about a genius doctor. And they used to play that the doctor would find a miracle treatment which would cure such serious illness. So students, today we have done half of the chapter. In our next video, we will continue with this chapter. Your homework is to go through the word meanings and also read the chapter up to taught. So that's all for today. Thank you.